Hello, in this video, we will learn the basic concept of an oscillator. But before moving into it, if you recall the amplitude modulation, where information signal is multiplied with the carrier signal and thus AM signal is generated. So from where does this carrier is generated? So this carrier signal is generated from the local oscillator. Now similarly, frequency mixture used in a superheated and receiver takes two frequencies at the input and produces the difference frequency at the output. So here one of the frequencies is the RF frequency and another frequency is nothing but the frequency generated from the local oscillator. So here in this two case we do require to produce a sinusoidal waveform, and these both are produced by local oscillator. So these are just two examples of local oscillators, but in many more places we do require oscillators. Now in digital circuit also, we do require to generate a pulse train. So that pulse train is also generated by a local oscillator. So this kind of oscillator generates a sinusoidal shape also and non-sinusoidal shape also, and it generates periodically. Now here our discussion will focus on an oscillator which produces sinusoidal shape only. So here in oscillator, it is an electronic circuit which generates output signal without any external input signal. So let us try to understand this sentence. But before that, if we recall the amplifier, so in amplifier, a waveform with small peak to peak is applied at the input, and at the output, we will get the waveform with the higher amplitude. So in case of amplifier, we do apply a waveform as input and we do get the waveform as a output. But in case of oscillator, it generates the output signal, but I will say that it generates the output waveform. Yes, it generates the output waveform without any external input waveform, without any external input waveform. So here I can say that in case of oscillator, there will be no input waveform. It generates only output waveform. So here we can say that no waveform is applied as a input. So no waveform at input is applied. So what is applied to the oscillator? So since oscillator is nothing but made up of active device, so and to make them work, we do have to apply some DC biasing. So only DC biasing, yes, only DC biasing is applied. DC biasing is applied to make that active element work. So some textbook also says that oscillator accepts the DC and produces the AC. So hope you understand this statement, that it is an electronic circuit that generates the output waveform without any external input waveform. So it do not require any input waveform, but it do produces output waveform of any shape. But here our concentration is sinusoidal shape, and this output waveform will be obviously periodic. Now here we have to apply only DC biasing. Now what is the basic concept of this oscillator? So this oscillator works on the principle of a positive feedback. So let us move to learn the positive feedback concept. So our next task is to learn positive feedback. So let us move to positive feedback. In positive feedback, let us first understand the feedback. In this configuration, let us assume that this one is an amplifier configuration with gain A, input VI, which is same as the source voltage, and VO is the output. Now in this configuration, we can say that by no means output is fed back to the input. That's why this configuration is called the open loop configuration or configuration without feedback. On another hand, if we sample some part of the output and feed back to the input, so that is called feedback configuration. Now this configuration, since part of the output is fed back to the input, so this forms a closed loop. So this configuration is also called a closed loop configuration or configuration with feedback. So here you can see that in open loop configuration, output is not fed back, but in closed loop configuration, output is fed back to the input. Now if we focus on this network, so here you can see that the output voltage VO is nothing but the A, that is gain times Vin. So here we can write down VO as the A times Vin. Now this output voltage is sampled by this feedback network, because in feedback, part of the output is fed back to the input. So that part will be sampled by this feedback network, and that's from the feedback. So here VF is nothing but the beta times VO, because this VO will be available over here. So VF is nothing but the beta times VO. So VF is nothing but beta times of VO, where beta is nothing but the gain of this feedback network. And this beta generally is having a fractional value. So that part is sampled and this fed back to the input. So here VS and VF are get mixed up, and that forms the VI. Now here, depending on the phase relation between the VS and VF, two kind of feedback are possible: positive feedback and negative feedback. Now here, in case of positive feedback, the phase relation between VS and VF is in phase. That is, if both are in phase, then that feedback is called positive feedback. On another hand, if the phase relation between VS and VF is out of phase, then that feedback is called the negative feedback. Now let us first start with the positive feedback. As it says, this VS and VF are in phase. What does it mean? If this one is the waveform of VS and second one is nothing but waveform of VF, so here we can see that when VS is having positive cycle, at the same instant of time VF will also have a positive cycle. Similarly, when VS is having negative cycle, VF is also having negative cycle. So at any instant of time, both will be in phase. So if that happens, that the sign at this mixing network will be both positive. So here you can see that VS also positive, VF also positive, and VI will be VS plus VF. So input of this amplifier network VI is VS plus VF. Now if we move on to the negative feedback, so here VS and VF will have out of phase relation. So here, if this waveform is of VS and the second one is of VF, so here we can see that out of phase relation means when VS is having positive cycle, VF will have a negative cycle, and so on. Now here, since VS and VF are out of phase, so here what will be the sign at this mixing circuit? So here you can see that VS will have positive sign, this VS over here will have positive sign, and VF will have a negative sign. So this overall input to this amplifier network will be VS minus VF. So here you can see that compared to positive feedback, input is VS plus VF. For negative feedback, it is VS minus VF. Now here, if we focus on this formula, so this formula is nothing but the relation between the open loop gain and closed loop gain. Now here, capital A is nothing but the open loop gain. So here we have already seen this configuration is nothing but the open loop gain, whose open loop configuration, whose gain will be A equals output upon input. So VO over VI, which is nothing but same as source. So this is nothing but A, open loop gain is A, and AF is nothing but the gain with a feedback. Now here beta is nothing but the gain of a feedback network, which will be fractional value. So this one is the relation between the gain with feedback and open loop gain. for the positive feedback configuration. Now here I will say that this quantity will be always fractional value. So this denominator will have fractional value. So as a result, this gain with feedback will be higher than the open loop gain. So in positive feedback, the gain with feedback will be higher than the open loop gain. Now in case of negative feedback, there is also a relation between the gain with feedback and open loop gain. So here gain with feedback is AF equals A upon 1 plus beta I, where A is nothing but open loop gain and beta is nothing but the gain of a feedback network. Now here if you concentrate, then here it is minus sign for positive feedback and here it is plus sign for the negative feedback. So there is a difference between the equation for positive feedback and negative feedback. Now in case of negative feedback, this quantity, this denominator quantity will be always greater than 1. So that's why this AF will be always less than A. So in case of negative feedback, gain with feedback will be less than the open loop gain. But here oscillator works on the principle of positive feedback. So this relation will be helpful for us to understand the functioning of an oscillator. So let us understand the working principle of oscillator with the help of this relation for a positive feedback. So first of all, let us derive this relation and try to understand the functioning of an oscillator. So let us derive this equation of AF. Let us derive the relation between gain with feedback and open loop gain for positive feedback configuration used in oscillator. So let us start from this point. Since it is a positive feedback configuration, so Vs and Vf will have in phase relation, so that here sign at the mixing circuit will be both positive. So here Vs positive sign, and for Vf also we do have positive sign. As a result, this Vi is Vs plus Vf. So we can write down Vi as a Vs plus Vf. Now gain with feedback is output voltage Vo divided by Vs. So gain with feedback for this configuration is Vo by Vs. But we know that Vi is Vs plus Vf, so we can write it down Vs as a Vi minus Vf. So here simply Vs is replaced by Vi minus Vf. So this Vs is replaced by Vi minus Vf. Now here Vf is nothing but the feedback voltage, which is beta times of output voltage Vo. So Vf is beta Vo. So let us replace Vf by beta times Vo. So here you can see that Vf is replaced by beta times Vo. Now let us divide both numerator and denominator by 1 over Vi. So on dividing numerator and denominator by 1 over Vi, we are left with Vo over Vi divided by 1 minus beta times Vo over Vi. Now here Vo over Vi is nothing but the open loop gain. So here our equation becomes Vo over Vi is nothing but A, 1 minus beta times also A. So this is 1 minus beta A. So here we can say that this is the relation between the gain with feedback and open loop gain. Now this relation will help us to understanding the function of oscillator. So let us try to put the various values of beta and get the understanding of functioning of an oscillator. So let us put various values of beta into this equation. So let us start with the relation between gain with feedback and open loop gain. So let us assume that for this particular configuration, gain of this amplifier is nothing but 20, and this gain is after considering the loading effect of this feedback network. Now let us put the various values of beta into this equation. Now beta is nothing but the gain of the feedback network, and this value of beta will be fractional because it is actually an attenuator network. So beta will have values in fractions. So let us put very first value, which is nothing but 0.005, into this equation. So we know A equals 20, beta equals 0.005, and if you calculate the AF, so value of AF will be 22.22. Now if we put another value of beta, which is 0.04, so in that case the value of AF will be 100. Now if you further increase the value of beta to 0.045 and put it into this equation and calculate the AF, so your AF will be 200. So here you can see that as we keep on increasing the value of beta, so here beta into VO, which is nothing but the feedback, also increases. And as feedback increases, since it is positive feedback, we can say that the gain with feedback also increases. Now for the last value of the beta, which is nothing but 0.05, so here we can see that 0.05 is nothing but, I can write it down as a 1 over 20. So if we try to put this value of beta into this equation, then A is already 20 and beta is 1 over 20, so beta into A becomes 1, and this denominator becomes 1 minus 1 is nothing but 0. So here we can see that when beta equals 1 by 20 and A is 20, so when beta equals 1 by A, okay, so when beta equals 1 by A, at that time this denominator will be 0 and your gain with feedback will be infinite. Yes, so if we adjust our beta, which is equal to 1 over A, at that time you can say that this particular circuit will provide infinite gain. But practically infinite gain is not possible, so this particular configuration will stop amplification and start oscillations. So when this condition happens, that is beta equals 1 by A, this will start oscillations. Now here at this particular configuration, beta equals 1 over A, AF is infinite, so if I put it over here, that my gain with feedback is infinite. So according to this equation, we can say that we will get infinite value if and only if Vs is equal to 0. So now this Vs is equal to 0 means what? Here in this configuration, we do not have to apply the external voltage. So without any external voltage, this will produce oscillations in the output. Now if Vs is 0, so we can say that Vi will be Vf. That means feedback voltage will be input of this circuit. Now here we know that feedback voltage Vf is nothing but beta times Vo. Here Vf is beta times Vo. So here Vf is nothing but beta times of Vo, and Vo is A times Vin. So here Vo is A times Vin. A times Vin. So here we can see that this feedback network will be input, this feedback voltage will be input voltage if and only if this beta A becomes 1. So it is a necessary condition that your feedback will be input if and only if your beta A will be 1. So here this beta into A is 1 is required to make this configuration as an oscillator. And what is this beta A? So beta A is nothing but the loop gain. So if you start traveling in this forward direction, then at that time your gain is A. Now if you travel into the reverse path, which is feedback path, so at that time your gain is B. So if you travel in this loop, so your gain is A into B. So that's why this beta into A is called a loop gain. And for oscillator, this condition is must, that beta into A equal to 1 or beta must be 1 by A. Now here beta equals 1, we can also write it down as a 1 angle 0 degree. Now here 1 is nothing but magnitude and 0 degrees shows the phase shift. So 1 says what? The magnitude of looped gain, that is loop gain is beta A. So magnitude of loop gain must be 1. And 0 degree says what? The loop phase shift. If you travel through this loop, then there must be 0 degree phase shift. So here 0 degree is nothing but loop phase shift. Loop phase shift. So here to make this configuration as an oscillator, this condition is necessary. And here these two conditions, which is nothing but magnitude of loop gain must be 1 and loop phase shift must be 0 degree. So these two conditions are required to work this configuration as an oscillator, and these two conditions are called Bark-Husen criteria. Yes. Now here, since no input is applied, external waveform is not applied, and feedback itself is working as a input. So here the question will be that what will be the first input to this circuit? Another will be, this circuit produces oscillations, so what will be the frequency of that oscillations? So these two questions will be cleared in short time. But before that, let us once again focus on this Bark-Husen criteria. So Bark-Husen criteria says beta into A must be equal to 1, which is nothing but magnitude of the loop gain must be equal to unity and loop phase shift must be equal to 0. So let us try to understand this Bark-Husen criteria for two different circuit configuration. First one is using non-inverting amplifier and second one is using inverting amplifier. So in the first configuration, here amplifier used is a non-inverting amplifier. So in that case, we know that since it is non-inverting amplifier, so output and input will be in phase. There is no phase shift between output and the input. So here we can see that there is 0 degree phase shift between output and input. Now this output is sampled by this feedback network and sent to the input. So here we can see that, okay, there is no phase shift between the input and the feedback voltage. Now here we can say that in case of inverting amplifier, we know that output and input is having 180 degree phase shift. So here we can say that there is 180 degree phase shift between output and input. Now when this output voltage is sampled via this feedback network and sent back to the input, so we can say that there is a 180 degree phase shift between input and the feedback voltage, which violates the condition of Vi equals Vf. In another sense, if we imagine that if we start traveling from this point, so here we are getting 180 degree phase shift in this forward path, and when we travel back to the origin, so we are getting only 180 degree phase shift, which violates the condition of 0 degree loop phase shift. So in this case, additional 180 degree phase shift should be provided such that total phase shift around the loop becomes 360 degree or 0 degree. To make that work, this feedback network has to provide additional 180 degree phase shift in the case of inverting amplifier configuration, so that this 180 degree phase shift in forward direction, another 180 degree phase shift in reverse direction, becomes 0 degree phase shift when it moves to the starting point. So here, instead of this, by addition of another 180 degree phase shift, you can see that now there is no phase shift between the feedback voltage and input voltage, which satisfies the condition of Vi must be equal to Vf in terms of phase also. Now in the case of non-inverting amplifier, we do not need any kind of phase shift via feedback network. So you can say that in this non-inverting amplifier case, this feedback network should provide either 0 degree phase shift or 360 degree phase shift. So here you can see that depending on the different configuration, this feedback network has to provide the different amount of phase shift. Now, how can we get the different amount of phase shift? So this feedback network can introduce different amount of phase shift because this feedback network uses a reactive components, and this reactive component can introduce phases, different phase shift. So here, by selecting the proper or different values of the reactive component, one can adjust the desired phase shift. Now, let us talk something more about beta into A and also try to solve the question that what will be the initial starting voltage in the case of oscillator and what will be the output frequency of oscillation in case of this oscillator. So let's get this answer. So let us first solve our two questions. What is the initial voltage for this oscillator circuit and what will be the output frequency? So starting voltage for this oscillator circuit is nothing but a noise voltage. So what is noise voltage? So we know that in any conductor at a room temperature there are some free electrons, and these free electrons will have random motion. Now due to the random motion there will be voltage generated, and that voltage is called a noise voltage. Now similar thing happens with the resistor present inside the amplifier circuit. Now that noise voltage will be generated by the resistor, and that noise voltage will be the very first input for the oscillator circuit. Now due to that noise voltage we will get some output. That output is sampled by the feedback network and once again fed back as an input. Now this happens continuously, and as a result we will get the output voltage. Now we know that noise voltage will have a very small amplitude, but we want a sufficient amplitude peak to peak at the output of oscillator. So how to get it? So for that let us discuss the loop gain. Now here for the loop gain beta into A, three different possibilities are there, which is beta A less than 1, beta A equals 1, and beta A greater than 1. So let us discuss one by one. So if beta A is less than 1, what does it mean? If you start your journey from this point, moves around the loop, and if you come back, then you can say that compared to previous input, current input will have lesser value because beta into A, that is loop gain, is less than 1. So if you keep on moving through this loop, then your amplitude will become decrease and decrease and decrease and decrease. So due to beta into A less than 1. Now if beta into A is greater than 1, then what happens? So here if beta into A is greater than 1, so if you start traveling from this point, moves around the loop, then you can say that compared to previous input, your current input will have higher value because beta into A greater than 1. So if you keep on moving through this loop, you will get higher and higher and higher voltage. But in oscillator, we require a constant or sustained oscillations. So for that, what to do? So for that, beta into A must be equal to 1, then and then we will get the sustained oscillations or constant amplitude. But initially we require beta into A greater than 1, then and then sufficient amplitude will build up, and later on once sufficient amplitude is built up, we want a constant amplitude. So that designer designs oscillator in such a way that they design oscillator by keeping beta into A slightly greater than 1. So initially as oscillator starts, beta A will be greater than 1, and after that they use the non-linearity of the circuit in such a way that after amplitude achieve certain level, your beta A will be automatically adjust to the 1 via non-linearity of the circuit. So in that sense this oscillator is designed. So initially beta A greater than 1, and after that circuit adjust, you got beta equals 1 and you will get the sustained oscillations. Now one thing also I have to say that designer designs this oscillator by keeping beta A into A greater than 1. If they keep beta into A equal to 1, then it may be possible that due to the timing or aging effect or due to component replacement, your beta into A may drops below 1. So designer designs your oscillator circuit by keeping not beta equals 1, but it keeps slightly higher than the 1. Now, next question is, what will be the output frequency for this oscillator circuit? So here, starting voltage is nothing but the noise voltage, and this noise voltage contains all frequencies. But out of this all frequency, only one frequency will get 0 degree or 360 degree phase shift around the loop, because we know the Barkhausen criteria that loop phase shift must be 0 degree or 360 degree. So the frequency which satisfies this criteria will be available at the output of this oscillator. And this frequency depends upon the design of beta network and also amplifier. So now let us look the practical oscillator circuit. Let us see the practical circuit configuration of RC phase shift oscillator. So if we focus on this block diagram, then in forward path we do have amplifier circuit with gain A, and in reverse path we do have a feedback network with gain beta. Now, in this amplifier, we can use any active device like BJT, op-amp or MOSFET. But here, op-amp and BJT are used as an active device for the amplifier configuration. So here you can see that in the first configuration, op-amp is used as an amplifier, and here BJT is used as an amplifier. Now here, in both of this case, this amplifier are in inverting mode configuration, means there will be 180 degree phase shift between output and the input, because here you can see that op-amp is connected in inverting configuration. So 180 degree output phase shift between output and input. Here also BJT is in CE amplifier mode, and all of you know that there is 180 degree phase shift between output and input in CE amplifier. So we can say that both of the configuration amplifier provides 180 degree phase shift. So we can say that 180 degree phase shift is there. Now, for oscillator, the Barkhausen criteria must be satisfied. That is, overall loop phase shift must be 0 degree. So if both of this configuration amplifier provide the 180 degree phase shift, then this beta network must have to provide additional 180 degree phase shift. So this additional 180 degree phase shift will be provided by this feedback network, and it is made up of this RC. So this is nothing but RC network in the feedback, and this will provide the additional 180 degree phase shift, because we know that pure capacitor can provide 90 degree phase shift, and RC combination can provide phase shift between 0 to 90 depending on the value of R and C. So that concept is used over here, and designer will select the RC combination in such a way that this whole network can provide 180 degree phase shift. So here you can see that designer will design in a such a way that this one RC combination provide the 60 degree phase shift, then three set of that will provide the 180 degree phase shift. So here we can see that if one set provides the 60 degree, next set another 60 degree, and the last set another 60 degree. So when your signal passes through this feedback network, then it will get 180 degree phase shift. So in short, overall loop phase shift will be 0 degree. This will also true for this configuration also. Now here our question is there, what will be the output frequency? So we learn that according to Barkhausen criteria, if the frequency which satisfy the 0 degree loop phase shift criteria, that will be available at the output. Now we also learn that output frequency also depend upon the design of this beta network. So here in simplest case, let us assume that if all capacitors are having same value and all resistors are having same value. So here you can see that if all resistors are having same value and all capacitors are having same value, then what will be the output frequency? So output frequency will be 1 over 2 pi RC under root 6. So you will get the sinusoidal oscillations at the output with this much frequency. Now here you can also see that if somehow you vary all these three capacitor, so if you somehow vary this C, then you can also get the sinusoidal with the variable frequency. So hope you get the basic understanding of oscillator theory. Thank you.